For years, high school diplomas have been the staple to prove to employers that students were capable of work. But what if there was another way to prove your employability that was bigger than just a diploma or a college degree?
The Governor's Work Ethics Certification Program is a program we started 3 years ago. What it does is it helps document employability skills for our high school students, or should I say our students in their last year of high school. It sort of captures things that aren't captured in the regular high school diploma, and this shows their skills, their persistence, their reliability, their organization skills, and shows employers that these are the future employees that they absolutely want.
It's only in year two, and it's starting to play out into something that's becoming very valuable for our students, as we find out that students are kind of rated on not only their attendance and tardiness in their discipline, but also on their ability to persevere in tough situations and a variety of other things, which helps employers to be able to start seeing right away if these are the kind of people that they think they would like to have. So whether it's students that are going into a job right away, if it's students that are going into the military, or if it's students going on to college, it can be very helpful for all three of them, because it helps to be able to show that you have met these requirements that make you the type of person that you'd like to have, whether it's in your university, in your military unit, or, you know, on the job.
Students across the Michiana area have been working hard to attain the Work Ethics Certificate, and many have already made plans to use it in the future.
I think it was last year or earlier this year, our principal had told us that there was this opportunity for us to win this certificate that would help us on job resumes, applications, different type of stuff. So we applied for it, and then we found out if we qualified and got it this past week.
It highlights stuff like being respectful, responsibility, and some things that like you don't necessarily aren't like statistic awards like GPA and stuff like that. So I think that's really good. It's like personality, and make sure people like are ready for the real world, basically.
It starts with the school and some local employers and a workforce partner or two, if available, coming together, forming a transition council. And this council will decide on the metrics that the students will have to go through in their final year of high school. Generally, it's pretty simple. It's a GPA of 2.0 or above, one or less disciplinary referrals. They need to have an attendance rate of 98% and have 6 community service hours. And once they do that, then they can roll it out for, say, students and their parents in the junior year of high school, kind of give them a preview of the program, or at the beginning of their final year. The students sign up in their final year. If they can go through the whole year and meet those goals, then they earn the Governor's Work Ethics Certificate.
Anytime I talk with local employers, they are very much in tune with this type of behavior. You know, I ask them, what is it that you want us to be teaching to these students? And they say things like, if you can teach them to be at work every day and to be at work on time every day, we can teach them the skills for labor that we need them to do. So this really plays exactly into that, because it gives them the idea, not only attendance and tardiness, but also some of the other skills for a teamwork and perseverance that will help them to be more successful when they get on the job as well.
Definitely the big one is job applications, or any time where I need to say something about me, I can say, this proves that I'm reliable, good in the classroom, outside of the classroom. So it's just kind of something that's there that proves backing up what I'm saying almost on the job application and stuff like that.
It gives them instant credibility with an entire network of employers. We have 160 schools and CTE centers right now implementing the program, and through them we have a network of 600 employers statewide in all 20 DWD recognized industries. So, a student here in Elkhart, if they earn the certificate, it's valid in Evansville, it's valid in Indianapolis, all around the state. And it can get you guaranteed interviews, increased base pay, flexible hours, you name it. There's all sorts of incentives that all of our employers provide. And there's also incentives too for some post-secondary institutions. A lot of them want to get in the game. They see the value in these students as well. So they are offering things as well.
Well, it always feels good when you do something that's good for the kids. And in our case here, I feel like we do a pretty good job of that all the time. It just kind of, it gives us a better sense that we, a way that we can, really know for sure that we are meeting the needs of the students. And we look at all those different aspects. There's 9 different areas that they have to look into and be good at in order to qualify. When these students, in this case 17 of them, when that many of them meet all of those requirements, then I guess it means we must be doing a pretty good job. So As a school, as a group of teachers, I wouldn't say there's a better staff anywhere around here. And I know we're doing a good job. This kind of goes to prove it.
Yeah, they were obviously proud of me for winning it. That's how they raised me. They expected me to win it. They expected me to not only be good in the classrooms, but to be respectful for the teachers and make sure I get back to the community. So they were happy and they were proud of me.